Well, Joe Biden's immigration policies have had at least one immediate effect. They've created a nationwide sanctuary for people driving drunk in this country illegally. Fox's Trace Gallagher has the full story on that for us tonight. Hey, Trace.
Hey, Tucker. Culpeper County, Virginia is relatively small, like 50,000 people, but the sheriff's office there has confirmed to Tucker Carlson tonight that in the past 2 weeks, two illegal immigrants with DUI convictions have been released from jail. One of the inmates had two DUIs, the other had one and was previously deported. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, or ICE, had detainers on both suspects, but under the new Biden administration policies, the agency was forced to lift the detainers and allow them to walk free. In other words, it's like sanctuary policies have expanded nationwide. Remember, ICE and other immigration agents can no longer deport illegal immigrants for crimes like assault, money laundering, property crimes, fraud, drug crimes, or DUI. Even Mothers Against Drunk Driving wouldn't comment on the policy. Quoting here, Matt expects all drunk driving offenders to be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law, no exceptions. The issue of deportation is outside the scope of Mad's life-saving mission. But during the campaign, Joe Biden promised he would do exactly this. Watch.
You only arrest for the purpose of dealing with a felony that's committed, and I don't count drunk driving as a felony.
Tell that to the families of Drew Rosenberg, Brandon Mendoza, and the dozens of other families Fox News has covered in recent years who lost loved ones to illegal immigrants driving under the influence. 3 weeks ago in Portland, Antifa held a violent protest calling for ICE to be abolished. One official told the Washington Post the Biden administration has now essentially abolished ICE without abolishing ICE. Tucker.
Trace Gallagher. Amazing. Thank you.
Yep.
So Mothers Against Drunk Driving is not mad that the Biden administration is giving a break to drunk drivers as long as they're illegal aliens. The story of this moment really is the story of the betrayal of people by their leaders.